Good morning, children. This biology class, we are going to see about the reproduction in plants. In the last class, we studied about the asexual reproduction and vegetative reproduction. Asexual reproduction and vegetative reproduction does not need any two kinds of plant, male and female and all. But the sexual reproduction needs male and female gametes. Okay, now in this class what we are going to see is sexual reproduction in plants. What is sexual reproduction? The fusion of two gametes result in the zygote. That is called a sexual reproduction. Okay, so what is sexual reproduction? The formation of new plant through the fusion of male and female gamete, that is the male and female gamete, is called a sexual reproduction. The formation of new plants through the fusion of male and female gamete is called sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is carried out only in the flowering plants. Why? Because the flowers are the reproductive organs. The stem, root, leaf, branches, in all these structures, the flowers only the reproductive organs of the plant. Okay, usually our flower contains male organ and a female organ. If both male and female organs are there, it is called as complete or bisexual flower. Complete or bisexual flower. If the flower is containing only the female organ and or the male organ, means it is incomplete or unisexual flower. Now you see in this flower, what are the four parts of the flower? Flower is having the calyx. Green color calyx will be there in the down of the flower. Then a beautiful colorful petals will be there, that are called a corolla. Okay, and the pistil and the stamens. What is called a pistil? Pistil is the female reproductive organ. It contains the ovary, ovule, style, stigma. The ovary, ovule, style and stigma together forms the pistil. Pistil is the female reproductive organ. Pen inapperikka urupu. Okay, children, now you see in this picture, there are some bag-like structures, isn't it? These are the anther. They are containing, the anther is containing the pollen grains. There are so many pollen grains are there in the anther. Okay, these pollen grains are male reproductive part. Now you see, the stamen is containing anther and filament. Anther and filament. Stamen is containing anther and filament. Which is anther? The bag-like structure. This is called anther. And these are all called filament. Filament. Okay. What is this called? This is ovary. What is this called? This is style. What is this called? Stigma. Together called pistil. Together called pistil. Okay, children. And male reproductive organ is stamen. What are the parts of stamen? The filament and anther. Filament and anther. What is there in the anther? The pollen grains are there in the anther. Okay. Now, let us go to the pollination. The pollination must be accompanied by the fertilization. Then only the fruits are formed, seeds are formed, and the reproduction is done by the plant. Okay. Now, pollination. What is pollination? The transfer of pollen grain from the anther to stigma of a flower. You see in this picture, the transfer of pollen grain from the anther, this is the anther, and to the stigma of the flower is called pollination. If the pollen grains fall on the same flower stigma, it is called self-pollination. Okay, if the pollen grains are falling from one flower to another flower stigma means that is called cross pollination. That is called cross pollination. What are the types of pollination? Self pollination and cross pollination. Okay, self pollination and cross pollination. Okay, now other things, the pollination is not done by self. Sometimes it may occur, but many times the agents of pollination are needed. What are the agents? Wind, water, insects, these are all the agents. The wind blows and takes the pollen grains from the stigma of the flower to another flower and help in pollination. So the wind pollinating flowers, pollen grains are large in number and very easy to, not brightly colored, but powdery and easy to carry away. Okay, and water. Next one is water. Water pollination is in aquatic plants called Vallisneria. Okay, in Vallisneria and all, in water itself, the pollen grains are liberated and they will be reaching the stigma of the female flower. Okay, and then insects. Insects also are playing the major role in the pollination. While they are sucking honey, they will sit on the flower and suck the honey. At the same time, the pollen grains will be, powdery pollen grains will be fixed with their leg. Okay, it stick to their body parts, a leg or body parts, wing. Yeah? So, they will be going to next flower just to put the pollen grains on the another flower. Okay, so that kind of flowers and all having brightly colored and good smelled, okay, brightly colored and good smelled, and also having rich in nectar. Nectar means honey. Okay, example, rose, sunflower and gulmohar. Many of the colorful flowers and all having the cross pollination, they are doing cross pollination. Even the hummingbird, that also having small narrow beaks and pollinating the flowers. Okay, and mammals also, bat and rodents also pollinate the flowers. Okay, children, next we can go to the after pollination. What is happening? The fertilization is happening. How the fertilization is happening? You see in this picture, you see the pollen grains are falling on the stigma. The pollen grain, then the stigma give the nourishment and the pollen grain grow a tube-like structure. Okay. After it grows the tube-like structure, it goes into the ovary till it reaches the ovule. This is the ovule. Ovule is the female gamete. Then the cells in the nucleus, female gamete, is called the ovule. The male gamete is called the pollen cells. Okay, the pollen nucleus and the ovule nucleus join together and form the zygote. That process is called fertilization. After the fertilization over, what will happen? After the fertilization over, the colorful petals and all dry and fall off. And the calyx sometimes, that also fall off. The ovary alone remains with the pedicel. Okay. So, after the fertilization over, immediately the ovary becomes the fruit. Okay. Ovary wall becomes the fruit wall. And the ovules become the seed. Okay. Ovules become the seed. Okay. So, ovary becomes fruit. Ovules become seed. Ovary wall becomes fruit wall. Okay. So, now the fruit is made. What will be there inside? The ovules are made, changed into seeds. No, that seeds will be there. What is there inside the seed? An embryo is there in the seed. Okay. That embryo is, whenever it is getting the condition of, favorable condition of air, water and temperature. Air, water, temperature and all. When it is getting, it begins to grow. That is called seed germination. Seed germination, you see, germinates. it germinates whenever the favorable conditions are available. Okay, children. Now you see this seed. You see here the seed is absorbing water and giving out small young plant, isn't it? Small plumule and radical comes out. Okay, in this seed you see radical. Radical means first formed root is called a radical. Okay, and then a small first formed shoot system comes out. You see in this seed, this is the radical, this is the plumule, this is the root, this is the root, this is the shoot system, stem. Okay, after this the baby plant grows nicely like this and grows into a new plant. Okay, this is the reproduction in plant through seeds. The seeds must be must not fall near the mother plant itself. Why? Because there will be a there won't be the minerals and the water and all not available for all seeds. So seeds must be put in some distant place. How can they throw the seeds? Through the seed dispersal. Seed dispersal. What is seed dispersal? The seed is taken away by the from the plant, mother plant, to the distant place. That is called a seed dispersal. This may be done by the explosion. In balsam plants and all, the fruit will dry and split open. Just bursted. Burst ஆகி அப்படியே வெடிச்சு இந்த குண்டுமணிலாம் உங்களுக்கு தெரியும்ல, குண்டுமணிலாம் அப்படியே வெடிச்சு செதறிடும். ஸோ எக்ஸ்ப்ளோஷன், அப்படியே வெடிச்சு செதறிடும். காய் அப்படியே வெடிச்சு செதறிடும். ஈவன் முருங்கைக்காய், முருங்கை. ஓகே, இந்த ட்ரம் ஸ்டிக் யூனோ தட் ஆல்சோ டூ த எக்ஸ்ப்ளோஷன். ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட்டு டிஸ்பர்சல் பை விண்ட். சம் ஆஃப் த சீட்ஸ் வில் பி டேக்கன் அவே பை த விண்ட். சம் வில் பி ஹேவிங் த பேராசூட் லைக் ஹேரி திங்ஸ் அரவுண்ட் த சீட்ஸ். ஓகே, ஃபார் தட் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இஸ் டெண்டலியன். Okay, dandelion, you know, the dandelion seeds, the tridax and all, they will be having the fur-like structure around the seeds. So, they can be taken away by the air. Okay, and the dispersal by water. Dispersal of seed by water, by the ocean or water current in the river, the coconut and all fall on the river itself, the river waves. Waves and ocean waves will carry the coconut and put in somewhere, and then there the coconut seed will grow. And another dispersal medium is by animals. The animals also, some seeds will be having hooks and some hooks and thorns and all that may fix on the body of the animals, grazing animals. When the animal goes and just shake their body in somewhere, the seeds will fall off. And the birds also eat some fruits like neem fruits and some of the fruits, banyan fruits, and they eat, and through their excreta, while they are sitting in some other place, they remove their excreta, isn't it? They put the excreta from excreta, the seeds will grow. When the rain is poured, they get the rainwater, and the suitable conditions all are available means they will also grow. You would have seen in the tall buildings and all, small people plant, neem plant and all, growing in the cracks of the buildings. That is because what? Because of the some birds are putting the seeds in the cracks of the buildings. Okay, so even when the animals are sticking, and the seeds are sticking with the animal's body, when they are rubbing off by the branches, okay, when they rub off their body in the branches, the seeds will fall down and grow into a new plant. Even ducks also, duck and all, they are living in the marshy places, in the pond and all, they know, they are in the wet, there is sand, mud will be wet and with water, isn't it? There are also some water living plant seeds will be there. That and all sticking on the legs of the duck, and a duck is going somewhere means the seeds and fruits will be dispersed. Okay, these are all the dispersal of seeds by animals by water, by air. Okay, now we can come to the conclusion. I mean, we can recapitulate what we studied in this lesson. Okay, first of all, we studied about the reproduction, that is sexual reproduction. That is the formation of new plant through the fusion of gametes to form a new plant. It's called a reproduction. What is the complete flower? If a flower is having the both male and female organs in the same flower, that is the complete flower. If one organ and only there means incomplete flower, we studied. And what is the female organ? Female organ is pistil. What is the male organ? Male organ is the stamen. Totally, which part is the reproductive part of the plant? Flower is the reproductive part of the plant. What is pollination? Pollination is the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to stigma, is known as pollination. What are the two types of pollination? Self-pollination and cross-pollination. One is self-pollination and another one is the cross-pollination we studied. Okay, after pollination, what is happening? The fertilization. Before the fertilization, we studied about the agents of pollination. What are the agents of pollination? Wind, water and insects we studied. And then after the pollination, what is happening? Fertilization happens. When the fertilization happens, what is made? The zygote is made. The zygote contains the embryo. Okay, now the embryo, after formation of the embryo, the ovary enlarges and forms the fruit. Ovules become seed. The ovary wall becomes the fruit coat. Okay, fruit ball. Okay, next day we studied about the seed germination. After the seed germination, what we studied? We studied about the seed dispersal. Seed dispersal is by the explosion. That means self. The dried fruit will be breaking out and liberating the seeds. And the dispersal by wind. Through wind, the seeds will be taken away. While it is taken away, how the seeds will be? They will be weightless or having the fiber-like or feathery appearance, feathery structures, which can be easily taken away. Okay, and then dispersal by water. Through water also some of the seeds are dispersed. The lotus seeds and all spongy, and the outer coat is very spongy and make them to float on water. Example, lotus, coconut. Okay. Next, brightly colored fruits are eaten by the animals, mammals and also by the birds. And wherever they excrete, through their excreta, the seeds will come out and grow into a new plant. And even ducks also, through their feet, they are dispersing the seeds we studied. Okay, children, now in this lesson, what are all the things we studied? Okay, what are all the things we studied? Reproduction, the asexual reproduction, and then sexual reproduction, stamen, pistil, self-pollination, cross-pollination, this and all we studied. Okay, fertilization, okay, and zygote, fertilization, zygote. Okay, now we are going to finish this lesson. I hope that you have understood well. If you are not able to understand, you have to go through the lessons very nicely and do the dictionary usage. Okay, dictionary usage you have. Any of the doubt is there means you can contact me and get clarified. You should not say enakku pidikkala enakku puriyavilla. You should not say. You must try to understand. Okay, you go through the book. Now I showed some of the words on the screen, some of the words it is hidden. But no problem, you study from the book. Okay, study from the book and understand nicely, well, nicely understand and get the meanings of all the words. Okay, first try to understand the lesson fully. Then you try to give the answer. Okay, ma? This lesson you have to study well, ma. And this is a very important lesson for your higher studies also. Okay? Okay, thank you, children.